Hey, I'm Steve from Email Tool Tester, and welcome to our MailChimp review. With their iconic cartoon chimp and playful design, MailChimp are probably one of the first newsletter tools that come to mind in the Western market. This is due, in no small part, to their far-reaching marketing campaigns. But does being well-known always mean a top-quality product? Let's take a closer look. MailChimp's pricing can be a little confusing to begin with, but let's split it into two parts. First of all, they have a free plan. This is aptly called Forever Free, and allows you to have up to 2,000 subscribers and 12,000 emails a month. It's worth noting that you will not be able to access some of the support channels, such as email and chat, on this plan, or advanced tools such as their automation. Plus, there will be a small MailChimp ad at the bottom of your emails. Next, they have their growing business plan, which offers the extra support and features, but the price is dependent on your subscriber number. This is the monthly payment option. They also have a pay-as-you-go option, which allows you to buy email credits, and may make more sense for people who don't send emails too often, or have too many subscribers but want the extras. The MailChimp dashboard is a pretty plain affair, but you can see things such as your audience growth and recent campaign statistics here. You also have quick access to recent activity. To create a new email campaign, you can either choose it from the main menu or click the button in the top right of the page. You then name your campaign and choose the type from a regular email to A/B testing or even Facebook ads, which is a new addition. We'll just create a regular HTML email. To begin with, you'll be shown both theme and template options to choose from. You can save your own templates and use them too. Once you're in the editor, you'll see the tools to the right and the preview pane on the left. Pop-up tips help you get your bearings, which can be useful for first-timers. What you see here is a test newsletter from one of our sister websites. As with other drag-and-drop tools, you can choose blocks from the right pane and drop them into the design on the left. Here's an example of adding an image in caption block. You then edit the content in the right pane, which you can also style with a few options. Clicking on any other box also allows you to quickly edit sections. The knowledge base is in easy reach from here, and works as a useful overlay, keeping the editing window underneath so you don't lose any of your work. Once you've completed your campaign, you can save and send it. MailChimp offer marketing automation, although it's really not that user-friendly. Other services such as ActiveCampaign offer a useful flowchart view, while MailChimp's is a basic list where it's quite hard to create dependencies between automatic emails. You have to know where to look to find triggers and other info, and the simplicity that works well for other parts of the site simply lead to a dull experience here. If automation is your main concern, we'd recommend looking elsewhere. One of the benefits of being a big fish in the email marketing space means that people want to bask in your limelight. This is good for MailChimp users though, because it means a ton of integrations are available. You can connect services to help build your lists or sell your wares with these e-commerce add-ons. You can also use integrations to help engage your subscribers, perhaps with SurveyMonkey or Twitter. There's pages and pages, so definitely something for everyone. MailChimp is easy to use, with its simplicity in design and drag-and-drop editor, and this probably adds to its widespread popularity. The reporting is thorough and contains basically everything you need, including client, geo, and social media tracking, as well as Google Analytics integration. Quite a few tools are available in their freemium plan, and you can have up to 12,000 emails and 2,000 subscribers, which isn't a bad deal. It's frustrating that marketing automation is available, but that it's been designed so unintuitively. It's not as advanced as some of the other tools out there either, so better look elsewhere if you need this feature. If you do need the pro features, MailChimp's prices quickly become very expensive after moving from their free plan. You can probably get better value out there if you really need pro features. We hope that you've enjoyed our video. If so, feel free to give us a like. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave us a comment. Thanks for watching.